In this old growth forest, the visibility is so great. I mean, you can see for hundreds of yards. I just want to scan here across the river with this thermal. Nothing yet. Let's keep moving upriver a little bit. This is some really good visibility. Let me go down here and take a scan. Hey, come here. Check this out. There's something down there. I'm getting a little hot spot right here. I have no idea. Oh, it's moving. It's moving. Look. Oh, it's gone. Just went into the trees. Let's go. Come on. He's right here. Check this out. Come here. Look, you can still see a residual heat signature. Whatever was here was standing right here. Are you seeing this? Look at that. See how it goes from cold, and then I move over right here. I mean, it's a really weird shape. Those look to me like where feet would be standing. But I don't know, it's hard to make out. I think we need to continue tracking whatever was here. Let's go.
See that? Something's been through here recently. This place just feels weird, doesn't it?
I've been hearing sounds that I'm not familiar with. It's spooky here. And that overall feeling, you can't escape it.
Look at that. Hold up.
But what I run into is a tree that's been plucked up out of the ground, roots and everything, turned upside down and jammed back down into the earth. You seeing this? The most unnatural thing I've ever seen in the forest.
See that distance right there? And then down here close to the ground is thinner.
I know that Ronnie and Maria have been doing an investigation on something exactly like this, but I've never seen it for myself. I'm wondering if it's telling me that it's dangerous to proceed or that I shouldn't be here. But something that is of nature and ripped from the earth and turned upside down doesn't feel like a welcome thing. I don't know if you're hearing that.
You see that?
Look at that. Balanced on an old, rotten stump is a tree that has been placed strategically across the top of it. Look at this.
It's just balanced up there like a seesaw.
At first glance, you think maybe it's just a large branch that fell from a tree above and just happened to land on top of this stump.
Just one little finger. Look at that. Look how long this stuff's been here. How would that have fallen from any of those trees?
This was done clearly with intent. Something smart placed this here, maybe as a marker, maybe to signal others, and then again, maybe as a warning.
You keep hearing that sound? It's almost like clicking or something hitting its teeth like a...
Oh, dude, look at this. There's another one. Okay, I've stumbled across my second one now. Another tree across an old rotten stump, also balanced perfectly on this log. You seeing that? That doesn't happen by accident. Look how fragile it is. This is a pattern. This place is, as Ronnie would say, chock full of high strangeness.
Now, I've never encountered anything like this in the forest before. I want to get a hold of Ronnie and Maria and just let them know what I've found.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Russ.
Listen, I'm getting some really, really strange activity in this area.
Like what?
What I found was a... Like an upside-down tree.
Oh, no way.
This thing's only about 6 or 7 feet tall. It's not like the big ones that you guys are looking at. But this thing's been here for a long time. It's got moss grown over it and everything else.
Something that's really wild is I found these
two separate spots where these logs are placed on top of old tree stumps.
They've literally been positioned
almost like in a seesaw manner, and they're balanced perfectly.
Like something placed it or just natural fall?
This is definitely with intent.
Logs on the top of stumps, man, that's
brand new from what I've heard in the different stories out here. If this is a tree structure, man, this is unlike one I've ever seen.
There's something else that you guys should know.
I keep hearing these clicking sounds.
I don't know if this is something that's normal
for Alaska, like a native wildlife sound that I'm just not used to yet, but it seems really, really strange because it didn't start up until I got in this area.
I mean, that doesn't sound familiar to me here, but if I talk about primates, then there is a very large monkey. It's a mandrill. It has a very colorful face, and it actually clicks and gnaws its teeth as a warning sign. It's actually a threat display.
I wonder if this thing is either threatened by me coming into the area
or if it's trying to push me out.
I mean, it's hard for me to say. I just know that it's not out of the realm of possibility because primates, they communicate in a number of ways.
All right, I'll let you guys know if I see anything else.
In the meantime, you guys just be careful.
Keep us updated, man.
What?
Do you see that?
Is that a skull in the tree?
That's not natural at all. Look at that. That thing right there was positioned there with intent. I'm facing something that I will admit, I don't like it. I have almost that sick feeling in the pit of my stomach. It looks like a goat skull or something, doesn't it? But it's wood. Looks like it's wood. It looks like a carving. When I realized it wasn't a skull, I thought maybe it was a wood carving, but it's not. What's very strange about this, this is all natural root system. There's sticks that are thrust into the earth, almost in a fashion where you're looking through this cage at this skull. But the way it was placed and presented and on full display was meant to startle whoever laid eyes on it.
Let's go back around. This is just weird.
Hang on a second.
Look, up against a tree right there. Do you see that? It looks like an upside down tree. I officially don't freaking like this place. I don't like it. I don't like this at all. Oh, jeez. Scared the crap out of me.
This feels like a sacrifice point or a spiritual thing happening here. This was all positioned with a reason. And I'm not sure that I want to know what that reason is. I wonder what else is out here.